Hello everybody, hope you all are safe and fine. Today we are beginning with lesson 13 of science, that is sound. So what all topics are we going to study in this chapter? Let us just have a chapter overview. We'll study about introduction about sound, propagation of sound, speed of sound. In this we'll compare it with the speed of light. Then important terms related to sound, then loudness and pitch, audible and inaudible sounds, range of hearing, then the human ear, the structure of the human ear, echo, reflection of sound, production of sound by musical instruments, sound produced by humans, noise and musical sound, and noise pollution. So these are the important topics that we are going to cover. So we'll be starting first of all with the introduction of sound. Sound is a form of energy produced by vibrations. Sound plays an important role in our daily lives. It helps us to communicate with each other. We hear a wide variety of sounds in our surroundings, and sound is produced by a vibrating body. Vibration is the to and fro or back or forth motion of an object. For example, if you strike a school bell, it vibrates and produces sound. If you pluck a stretched rubber, it vibrates and produces sound. So that means what? That sound is produced by the vibrations. Next we have is the propagation of sound. Sound requires a medium to propagate. Sound travels through solids, liquids and gases. Sound does not travel in vacuum. For example, sound travels through the solid thread of a telephone. A whale listens of a reflected sound in water to locate its prey. We are able to listen to sounds because sounds travels in air. So that means that sound needs a medium to travel. Next we have is the speed of sound. Speed of sound depends on two things, elasticity and density. Elasticity is the ability of an object or material to resume its normal shape after being stretched or compressed. Density of the medium through which it propagates. In case of air, it also depends upon the temperature of air. The speed of sound through air is about 330 meters per second. The speed of sound through water is about 1500 meters per second. The speed of sound in solid is the highest, then in the liquids and then in the gases. That means the speed of sound in gases is the least. And if we talk about the relationship, then speed of sound is equals to wavelength of sound into the frequency of the sound produced. Next we have speed of light versus speed of sound. The speed of sound in air is about 313 meters per second. The speed of light in air is about 3 into 10 raised to the power of 8 meters per second. Speed of light is faster than the speed of sound. That is why the thundering sounds are always heard a little after seeing the flash of lightning. Both lightning and thundering occur together. Delay in hearing is due to the difference in the speeds of sound and light. Now we will study about some important terms related to the sound produced. First is vibration and oscillation. Vibration is the to and fro or back and forth motion of an object. Vibration is also called oscillatory motion. The motion of the pendulum from one extreme position to the other extreme position and back is called an oscillation. That means in the figure we can see A to B and then back to A. Next we have the frequency of sound wave. The number of oscillations per second is called frequency. It is represented by the Greek letter nu, and the unit of frequency is hertz. Next important term is time period of a sound wave. The time taken for one oscillation is called the time period. It is represented by the letter capital T. The SI unit is second. Frequency and time are represented as time equals to 1 upon frequency or 1 upon nu. Now, and nu is given for one oscillation as 1 upon t. So this is the relation between time period and the frequency. Next we have the amplitude. The maximum distance or the maximum displacement of an oscillating body from its central position is called its amplitude. Like here we can see in the pendulum OB or OA. Or in other words, the amplitude of sound wave is the height of the crest or tuff. It is represented by a letter A. The SI unit is same as that of density and pressure. Next, now the topic which we have to study is about the loudness and the pitch of sound. The loudness of sound depends upon the amplitude of vibration. If the amplitude is less, the sound is feeble. If the amplitude is more, the sound is loud. The SI unit of loudness is decibel, represented by dB. Next we have the pitch of sound or the shrillness or flatness. It depends on the frequency of vibration. If the frequency is less, the sound has low pitch. For example, sound of a drum, sound of an adult, etc. If the frequency is more, the sound has a high pitch. For example, sound of a whistle, sound of a baby, etc. So this is the loudness and pitch of the sound. Next we have the audible and the inaudible sound. Audible sound means, audible sound is sound which we can hear. It has frequencies between 20 Hz and 20,000 Hz. Inaudible sound is the sound which we cannot hear. It has frequencies less than 20 Hz and more than 20,000 Hz. Sound whose frequencies is more than 20,000 Hz is called ultrasonic sound. Some animals like dogs can hear ultrasonic sound and bats produce ultrasonic sounds. Okay, next topic that we have is the range of hearing. That means how much we can hear. In this, we will study about the ultrasonic and the infrasonic sounds. Human beings can hear sound frequencies between 20,000 to 20,000 Hz. Sound whose frequency is less than 20 Hz is called infrasonic sound. Animals like dogs, elephants, rhinoceros, whales, they produce and hear infrasonic sounds. Sound whose frequency is more than 20,000 Hz is called ultrasonic sound. Animals like dolphins, bats, rats, then porpoises, they all hear ultrasonic sounds. Bats use reflection of ultrasonic sound waves to detect an obstacle or its prey. So we can say that the audible range is how much? 20,000 to 20,000 Hz. Next, we have to study about the human ear and the structure of the human ear. Now, how we hear the sound through our ears? Sound enters the ear through the ear canal. It makes the eardrum to vibrate. The eardrum sends the vibrations to the inner ear. From there, the signals go to the brain and when we hear the sound. If we study about the structure, the outer ear called pinna collects the sound waves. The sound waves pass through the ear canal to a thin membrane called the eardrum. The eardrum vibrates. The vibrations are amplified by the three bones of the middle ear called the hammer, anvil and stirrup. The middle ear then transmits the sound waves into the inner ear. The inner ear, the sound waves are converted into electrical signals by the cochlea and sent to the brain through the auditory nerve. The brain then interprets the signals as the sounds. So this is the way how the sound is traveling in our ear. Next we have is the echo. The repetition of sound produced by the reflection of sound waves from a wall, mountain or other obstructing surface is called an echo. If we shout or clap near a reflecting surface like tall building or a mountain, we hear the same sound again. This sound which we hear is called the echo. Echo is caused due to reflection of sound. To hear an echo clearly, the time interval between the original sound and the echo must be at least 0.1 second. Okay, So if we take the time period as 0.1 second and the speed of sound in air is 330 meters per second, so the distance comes out to be 33 meters. So the minimum distance between the reflective surface and the production of sound should be approximately 17 meters. Okay. Next we have is the reflection of sound. Like light, sound also gets reflected at the surface of a solid or liquid and follows the laws of reflection. In this again, the angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. The incident ray, the reflected ray and the normal at the point of incidence, they all lie in the same plane. Okay. Next topic that we have is the production of sound by the musical instruments. Now in this we will see different kinds of instruments and how do they produce the sound. So the production of sound by musical instruments depend on the type of instruments. There are four types of instruments: woodwind, string, percussion and brass. So first we will see the woodwind instruments. Woodwind instruments make music by blowing on the top or on a reed of the instrument. Examples we can see here: flute, then the clarinet, piccolo, bassoon, all are known as the woodwind instruments. Next are the stringed instruments. String instruments make music by plucking or strumming the strings. For example, the violin, guitar, the electric guitar, the harp, they are all the examples of string instruments. Next are the percussion instruments. Percussion instruments make music by striking, shaking or scraping them. For example, the drum, the tambourine, the piano, then the xylophone, they are all the examples of percussion instruments. Last we have is the brass instruments. Brass instruments make music by buzzing lips while blowing. For example, the trumpet, the French horn, they are examples of the brass instruments. Next topic that we have is the sound produced by the humans. Sound produced by the humans. In humans, sound is produced by the voice box or the larynx. It is the upper part of the windpipe. Two vocal cords are stretched across the voice box, leaving a narrow slit. When the lungs force air through the slit, it vibrates and it produces sound. So what do we know? That the voice box is known as the larynx. Next we have is the noise and the musical sound. Now in this we are going to see noise first. Noise is the unpleasant sounds are called noise. It is produced by irregular or non-periodic vibrations. For example, if all the students in a classroom speak together, a noise is produced. Musical sound. Sound which is pleasing to the ears is called the musical sound. It is produced by regular or periodic vibrations. For example, sound produced by the musical instruments, sound of a person singing a song. So this is the difference between noise and the musical sound. Next we have is the noise pollution. The presence of excessive or unwanted desirable sound in the environment is called the noise pollution. Causes of noise pollution are: noise pollution is caused by sounds of vehicles, explosions, including bursting of crackers, machines. In the home, noise pollution is caused by television, radio, music systems, kitchen appliances, air conditioners, etc. Harmful effects of noise pollution. Noise pollution causes several health-related problems like lack of sleep, hypertension, high blood pressure, anxiety. A person exposed to loud sound continuously may get temporary or permanent impairment of hearing. Measurements to limit noise pollution. Noise pollution can be reduced by using silencers in vehicles and industrial machines, planting of trees along the roads and buildings to help to reduce noise pollution. So, what all things have we seen in this chapter? We have seen about the sound, important terms related to sound, then audible ranges. Then we have studied about the human ear, how the voice box produces the sound, and then we have studied about different instruments and noise and noise pollution. This is all which we have to cover in this chapter. The question answers will be given in the description box, And next we will meet with the next chapter. Till then, stay home and stay safe. Thank you.